Hey guys, this is Kirat and welcome back to another video. So today I'm going to be talking about the OnePlus Student Ambassador Program 2020. And if you have been following me for the past 6 or 7 months, you might know that I was selected as a OnePlus Student Ambassador in the 2019 batch for Manipal University. So it has been around 9 months now since I have been working with OnePlus. So first I completed the 6 month SAP 2019 batch. And I was one of the top 5 ambassadors of that batch. So it was a really exciting journey. And if you want to know about the amazing events and the benefits of this program, I would highly recommend you to watch my vlog series in that I've taken you to the OnePlus launch event, the OnePlus music festival, Open Ears Forum, OnePlus Bangalore meetings and whatnot. So there's a lot of motivation for you if you watch my vlogs. And it will be a fun experience as well. So after the initial batch ended in February, OnePlus gave me and 6 other students an extended term of 3 months. So I was working with OnePlus until May of this year. So I recently just officially ended my journey with OnePlus. So it has been a very exciting experience, full of learning, full of fun. And yeah, I want you to experience the same. So that's why I'm making this video. Now let's come to the point. I'm making this video to guide you through the application of OnePlus SAP 2020. And that's the whole focus of this video. As I said, if you want to know about the benefits, the experience and everything, you can watch my videos, my other videos. But this is purely gonna be to guide you through the application. Now, before we dive into the application, I want to inform you that so I've made a Telegram group named OnePlus SAP 2020 mentorship group. So the link is in the description. Go join that group. There you can interact with me one-on-one and, you know, interact with other applicants as well. You can ask your doubts, interact with me, and I will be able to help you there. But I just want to request that please do watch this video completely and follow everything I say here before asking, you know, the same things in the Telegram group, because it will be very difficult for me to explain you everything one after the another when I have already explained you everything in this video. So I highly recommend you to make notes throughout this video, because there's going to be some information that you're gonna need handy while you fill out your application, so you don't have to come back to this video again and again. So my friend and co-ambassador Sayam has already written a really great Medium article on this topic, on how you can improve your application for SAP 2020, and he provides a lot of interesting insights which will really help you. So now let's finally start by opening the SAP form. I'll just open it in front of me so we can go through every question one by one, and I'll keep explaining you the important points as they come. So we can see the first few questions are very, you know, are very generic. I don't have to tell you anything in this. Name, age, email address, mobile, college, year of college, course. So one important point that I would like to state is that I don't think there has been any ambassador who got selected in his or her first year of college. So that's something you should keep in mind. The logic behind this is the whole foundation of SAP is that you know your college really well and you can help conduct events and you have a great contact list in your college, and so you can manage things really well on your own. So I think a first year student is going to have a hard time with this, because they are just figuring things out in college. They are new to clubs, new to events or fest. So I'm not saying that they won't select a first year in this program, but I think the probability is really low. So I don't want to demotivate you from applying. I'm just telling you what it has been for the past 2 batches. So after you fill all this, you're gonna come across IG link. So this is basically your personal Instagram profile. Now, please don't go crazy and put OnePlus-y things in your bio, such as OnePlus fanboy, OnePlus community member or stuff like that, just for the sake that they might open your profile and check it or something. So I would say just keep it natural, just keep it however it is. If you want to make it public, make it public, or just let it be private. So that's your choice, but I just want to say that don't make your profile look like you're a OnePlus fanboy or something. That won't really help. So coming to the next link, that is portfolio link. Now, as you can see, this is not a mandatory question, and that is because this is mainly for the social media team, the students who are applying for the social media team, because here you can insert actually your past work. So if you are a designer and you have done some creatives in the past, you can make a nice website. That's really easy to make these days. You can make a nice portfolio website, or you can make an Instagram account as well, just to show off your creative work or whatever you could feel like. I mean, it's your work, you know the best way to represent it. If you have a YouTube channel like me, so you can put your YouTube channel link over here as well. That'll help. So one thing you should keep in mind, that this field is not for uploading your CV or your LinkedIn profile. I personally confirmed with the OnePlus team myself. So don't put your CV in this form. It is not asked for. So don't try to put it in this form or any other field. Okay, so now we are at the main questions, and these are the most crucial ones. These are your make or break questions of this application. So the question is, why do you want to apply for OnePlus app? And I'm not gonna tell you what to write, because this is a very personal question, a very subjective one. Instead, I'm gonna talk about what I wrote and how, you know, that helped me connect with OnePlus team. So the basis of my application was that I was a OnePlus community member since 2014. So that was the point around which I revolved my entire application around, and I was using OnePlus forums, which you might be familiar with. If you check the OnePlus student community section for the SAP 2020 form. If you don't have a OnePlus forum account, I would recommend you to please create it right now after this video, because you know that plays a very important role. And you can use the forum to directly interact with the OnePlus team that is handling the SAP applications. So that will be useful there as well. So I was a OnePlus community member from 2014. I was following all the brand's launches. I was following the brand on social media since a long time. I was making threads on the OnePlus forum, taking part in competitions. So naturally, I had a lot of knowledge about OnePlus from the start. I didn't have to do any research for answering this question. But if you're new to OnePlus, or you just know OnePlus by, you know, using their devices, and you haven't really read the story of the company or know how it started, what it stands for, I would really push you that you please read the entire story of the brand before writing your application, because you know it might not be required for the application right now, but I assure you that if you know the story behind OnePlus and OnePlus as a brand properly, that will surely help you in the upcoming rounds. And I'll just tell you one important point that you should research on yourself, that is five values of OnePlus. Now, this is a very important thing to OnePlus as a company. They always stand behind these five values. Now, I won't tell you what those values are. I'll leave that to you. So make sure you read about those. Now, I would like to warn you about one very important thing, that throughout this application, do not write OnePlus, that is a capital O and a capital P, as OnePlus with with just a capital O or just a capital P. You need to write OnePlus as OnePlus, not this, not this, or not this. And the same goes for never settle. In never settle, there should be a space between never and settle, and both N and S should be capital. So these are the things OnePlus is really strict about, and you might be thinking that why are they focusing on this? Well, you will, when you read about OnePlus, you will find out that they are all about the details, and this is something that they definitely care about. And there's a high chance that if you don't do this correctly, your application might get rejected before they even, you know, read it. So this is one important point that you should take note of. So now let's move to the next question, which is a new addition to this edition of SAP. So the previous two SAP batches never had any concept of teams. So basically you have a content team, a community team and tech team this time. But for SAP 2018 and SAP 2019, there was no concept of these teams. Okay, so I'm gonna explain you all the three teams one by one. And I hope by now you already have an idea of the team you want to apply to. So let's start with the content team, which is personally my favorite because I did a lot of content work in SAP. And as you can already guess, I have been making YouTube videos since all these years. So I have a fair amount of idea about how to produce good quality content. And I think I was able to display it in my tenure of SAP. So now, again, like the last answer, I won't tell you what to write over here. I'll share my experience. The idea behind me telling you my experience is that you'll identify what are they looking for. So you can be the judge for yourself. If I tell you what to write, there won't be uniqueness. I mean, there would be 100 applications following the same structure, the same keywords and everything. But if I tell you that what they are looking for, you can be completely unique and stand out with your answers. So let's start with the social media team. This will be the most competitive team, I think, because nowadays everyone has some sort of presence on social media in terms of blogs, content creation, or creatives or designing and all of that. Okay, so now let's talk about what are they looking for in the content team of SAP 2020. So I'd like to clear this out up front. They are not going to be looking if you are a highly trained designer or a highly trained copywriter. What they will be looking for, according to me, is the student content sense. Now, what I mean by student content sense is I'll be explaining it to you in a lot of detail, because as I said, this is something I worked for a lot during my tenure. I'll be explaining you this entire student content sense term by giving you two examples from my time and the content pieces I worked on. So let's start with the first example. The first example is a campaign that I did for OPMF. So OPMF stands for OnePlus Music Festival. It was held on November 16th last year in Mumbai, and it was one hell of an event. So anyways, before the event, we were assigned a task where we had to develop creatives to promote the event in our respective colleges. Now, OPMF is an event that is aimed at the young crowd, right? Katy Perry, Dua Lipa, Ritwiz. OnePlus was expecting that the young crowd is the one that will be the most interested in this festival. But the thing is that this event happened in Mumbai, and you can't expect, you know, that students in Manipal or BITS Pilani or NIT Trichy and all other colleges will actually buy the plane tickets, will buy the expensive concert tickets, buy the hotel night stay and attend the event. So what I had to figure out was I don't have to sell them the tickets. Rather, I have to figure out a way for them to relate to this event. So directly marketing discount on tickets or using the exact same marketing material as OnePlus was not the best idea, because it would result in a very bad performing creative and it won't create much of an impact. So I put my thinking cap on and I spent a couple of days thinking about how I can relate this music festival to the students of Manipal. So after a lot of brainstorming, I came up with this idea, which actually ended up performing really well. So the idea was that I will make a series called What If OPMF Artists Were From Manipal. So the basic idea behind this was to relate Manipal students to the OPMF artists. And as the OPMF artists were Katy Perry, Dua Lipa, who are already so popular among college students, I was expecting that they will for sure like this content and share it across with their friends. So you can see on your screen the creatives that I had made for this, that that I worked on for this campaign. And by now I think you should have a good idea about what I meant by student content sense. Alright, so the second example that I want to share is, so what I did for the Holi campaign in OnePlus app. So this you will relate to this even more after the last example. So Holi was coming up and I wanted to make a campaign again that college students could relate to, but the difference this time was that I had to create something that would be posted on all 25 pages of OnePlus app. So it was not about me relating to just Manipal students, it was me relating to the entire student community of India. So this was a lot more difficult than the previous creatives, but it took a lot of brainstorming sessions and I was finally able to come up with this campaign that again performed really well, and I believe this is the best social media work I've done in SAP. So these are the creatives that I created for this campaign. And you can see that all the creatives basically really mold together three things. First is OnePlus, obviously. Second is colors, Holi. And third is students. Alright, so this is something that the entire student community can relate to. I mean, come on, you always know someone who wakes up late and still reaches class before you or on time. So we all know someone like that, and I was expecting that obviously that students would be tagging their friends on this, having fun in the comment section, sharing this on DMs, and that is again exactly what happened. I saw a lot of students were tagging their friends, calling out each other. This speaks for itself that this is relatable content. So I think by now you should have got the entire idea about how the student content team was working in SAP and how and what they basically expect from you. So moving to the next team, which is the community team, and I think this will be the second most popular team for SAP 2020. This is basically where you organize events on your campus. Due to COVID-19, there's a huge chance that you might stay limited to online events this time. But in my batch, the SAP 2019, we had so many offline events. So I'll give you an example of three events that I conducted. Two of them are offline and one is online. So the key takeaways for you from my examples of this community team should be, what events would you like to organize in your college if you were a OnePlus ambassador? So this was explicitly a question in SAP 2019 application form. It has been removed now, but I think if you're selecting the community team, if you talk about the events that you might wanna organize if you are a OnePlus student ambassador, I think it's a really great approach to this answer. So the first event is OnePlus Manipal Photo Walk. This is the first event that I organized in SAP. So the SAP 2019 batch began on 1st August 2019 and this event was held on 19th August 2019. I organized this with my co-ambassador Saurabh. Manipal has a lot of great beaches. So what we planned was we booked two private buses which were paid for by OnePlus. And we basically took a crowd of 80 students in those buses to a beach nearby, and we had a really great time. I mean, it was an amazing experience organizing this event. And yeah, that's it. The second offline events, or rather this is a series of events that I organized, were OnePlus Academy workshops. So here I basically collaborated with some of the best clubs in Manipal to organize educational and academic focused workshops. So there was no OnePlus element in this workshop. So it was a OnePlus Academy, but it's not like we were promoting anything OnePlus or promoting our Instagram page in that event. And even though like OnePlus wasn't related, the students were really excited that they're going to attend a OnePlus community event. So we covered various topics such as aerodynamics, hyperloop, drones, and each one of these workshops had around 60 to 65 participants. So they were extremely successful. Now coming to the online part, so I did this during the COVID lockdown, and I think this is about the third week of March when I was thinking about organizing an online gaming night, because the lockdown had just started and everyone was like into gaming, into PUBG. Everyone was chilling out. Everyone was free basically. So I thought that it'll be nice to organize a OnePlus student community gaming night, and it might be a fun experience. So I did not have much expectations at all from the event. I expected around 100 students to fill up the form, but it eventually blew up and we had 300 students registering for the event. Now, if you are familiar with PUBG Mobile, you know that if 100 participants are there, you can just create one room, share ID, password, and that basically is your match. You can conduct your match with 100 people. But this time, 300 students signed up, so I had to figure out how to conduct those three rooms. And the challenge was that I had already declared that the event was going to go live at 9 PM. So it wasn't like I could tell the other 200 students to basically wait till 9:30 or 10 till I create another room. So it was actually crazy. I had to create a WhatsApp group of 300 people. I had to manage this huge Excel sheet and convert it to contacts, then load it into my phone, add everyone manually. It was a lot of work, but it turned out really well. In the end, everything was successful and we basically hosted 300 students simultaneously on PUBG Mobile. So as you can see that, again, there's a lot of flexibility in what you can do. Now you can do a gaming event offline, you can do a gaming event online, you can do workshops, you can do photo walks. This is what the community team of OnePlus is about. And I think, yeah, this, I have explained this in a lot of detail. I think the students who were confused about the community team, that what exactly you have to do, I think this clears everything. Now coming to the tech team. Now this is a new division. It wasn't there in the last SAP batch, in the last two SAP batches. So I did not pursue anything in tech in my tenure. So I don't have my own examples like the other two teams, but my friend and co-ambassador Mrignang from Bits Pilani worked in this team for 3 months from Feb to May. And he was basically pursuing different kinds of projects. And one of the projects he told me about was that they were working to basically use the OnePlus camera module in an autonomous car. And that car was going to be completely dependent on the OnePlus 8 to provide the image data or the image sensory data, whatever. So as you can see, this is a perfect implementation of tech with student projects where you are using the OnePlus device to connect it into a real life student project. So not only this shows the power of a OnePlus device, that it can be used to power an autonomous car, or that is just one example, there can be hundreds of them, but you're also empowering the OnePlus student. So you're also empowering the student team. It's a win-win for both sides. And as I said, I don't have much information about this team, but I hope that the example I just gave you helped you identify that what exactly they are looking for. My advice for this part, if you're applying for this, would be that write about how you can use OnePlus and integrate it into student projects or student teams, or maybe if you have a project idea of your own in your mind, write about that. So yeah, that's basically the tech team. I think now you guys should have a fair idea of all three teams. I have explained it to you in a lot of detail. I don't think I've spoken this long in quite a while. So yeah, I think let's move to the next question. All right, so the next question is, where did you hear about the SAP? So you can fill wherever you have heard about. So you can fill whatever you want here. And now coming to the last question, this is again a new addition to this program, and this is the Red Cable Club. If you don't know what is Red Cable Club, I'll just link you to my vlog over here, which is OnePlus Open Ears Forum Red Cable Club. And I'll just explain it to you briefly. Red Cable Club is a new membership program that has been launched by OnePlus, and all OnePlus users can basically become a part of it. You get some exclusive benefits like free music subscriptions and exclusive news and free cloud storage and much more. So this is the Red Cable Club. Now, the question says, mention three student-centric benefits that you'd like this membership program to offer. This question is actually very near to my heart because of one reason. So I told you about OnePlus Open Ears Forums, right? So Open Ears Forum is basically OnePlus choosing a topic and then inviting 30 community members from all over India on the basis of an application form just like SAP. And you basically have to answer different types of questions about that topic. And if OnePlus finds that you can, you know, add value, they, you are selected for OnePlus Open Ears Forum. So I was selected for OnePlus Open Ears Red Cable Club, and the application form for that had this exact same question, except that this one has student-centric because obviously it's a SAP form. But the question I had to fill was, mention three benefits that you'd like this membership program to offer. This was the exact same question. I spent about 3 hours writing the answer for this, because I was really passionate about Open Ears Forum and I did not want to miss that opportunity. That paid really well. So three student-centric benefits. So I'll just give you the thinking direction over here. So think about the services that a student uses or a student wants in his daily life. So you listen to music, right? So you might have a music app. Now, if Red Cable Club gives a free music subscription to its members, then the students would be really happy and interested, you know, because music apps are something students use on a daily basis. That's what happened. That's what was suggested in the Open Ears Forum as well. Everyone suggested that there should be a music membership program inside of Red Cable Club. And recently, OnePlus gave away 3 months of free Gaana Plus membership to all RCC members. So that is one benefit. Now, don't write about this. Now, I know that this must be a hard question to answer for you. It was for me as well. As I said, I spent about 3 hours writing this. But this is where it makes all the difference to your application, right? If you stand out in this question, which is really hard for others, so it speaks a lot for you by itself. So if I had to just give you an example out of the blue, that it would be, if you are an RCC member and you are a student, then if you plan on upgrading to a newer OnePlus device that has just been launched, you'll either get like a 5% student discount under RCC, or maybe you get some free accessories like a Bullis Wireless Z. So this is just one benefit example that I could think of the top of my head, but you have to write about three. So make sure that you spend a good amount of time on this question. And yeah, I think that wraps up our entire application form. So guys, thank you for watching this video. I hope this video helped you a lot with going about your application for SAP 2020. I know this can be a really hard application to fill. It was for me. I spent about 7 to 10 days, if I remember correctly. So don't feel overwhelmed if you find yourself thinking about this every day for the next 2 weeks or something. Reach out to me for any help. I've already told you that you can join my Telegram group if you want and everything. So yeah, I'll end this video over here. Subscribe if you like this video. So like this video if you found it helpful, dislike if you did not, and I'll see you in my next video.